Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Simon here with another episode of Star Trek Picard to Watch. And whilst the world may be burning outside, I am still going to be bringing you content, no matter what, even if I manage to catch coronavirus, which so far, thankfully, I've managed to avoid. Although, knowing my luck, I'll probably get it at some point. Still, what we have to talk about here is Star Trek Picard. And last episode, Nepenthe, was the best episode so far, without doubt. And it felt so good seeing Riker, Troy, and Picard back together. It just felt like we'd never been away, you know, from the Next Generation. All three of them, and in particular, Marina Sirtis, did a fantastic acting job. I can only imagine what it's like as an actor, spending so much time away from a character. In this case, it's been, I think, 17 years since the Next Generation crew would have been together, you know, and filmed Nemesis. And so for them to have to step back into their character roles after that long and hit it like they hit it was brilliant, you know. And, you know, big ups to not just Sir Patrick Stewart, but, you know, Jonathan Frakes and Marina Sirtis as well. They both just fell right back into the roles. And, you know, if I was just listening, they sounded exactly the same. You know, I wouldn't have guessed that these were people who have been away for so long and their characters had aged. You know, they were the characters, and I loved it. You know, especially Troy's, you know, monologues to Picard, you know, about the poor, you know, poor Soji, and everything that she's been through. And she kind of gave us a new perspective on Soji and how, you know, she can't trust anyone. You know, trusting has hurt her, and she was designed to trust, you know, and that's kind of led her to where she is now. And so, you know, we also learned about, you know, their painful past. And again, this is a credit to Marina Sirtis. When they were talking about their son who'd passed away, she gave such a convincing performance that even though the character never appeared on screen, this was the first time we were hearing about the character, immediately I was convinced, and I felt the character and the history of the character. You know, I thought it was a fantastic episode. And whilst that stuff wasn't the only stuff that happened, that was definitely the central element of the episode, and I loved every minute of it. I loved the slower pace. I loved, you know, just seeing those characters interact again. And then on the ship, you know, you've got obviously Raffi, who was trying to console what's her name now? I've got the names down on this. The blonde scientist woman, is it Helga? Hilda? Something, I can't remember for the life of me. There's been so much going on. But we saw, obviously, what happened between Commodore O and her character. And she'd been given a chewable tracking device. And that's how the Romulans were now tracking them. And obviously, all this guilt was building up and building and building up. And she drank some kind of a corrosive substance to dissolve the device. And so now the ship, at least, is in the clear. And we can carry on. Wherever, well, we're presumably going to be heading to wherever Brad Maddox was, you know, building these androids, because there is only 3 episodes left, so I'm guessing we're going to get to a bit of a climax of that. And the preview for this episode looked really interesting. A lot of it focuses on the Borg cube, which we see 7 of 9 pop back up. I'm very interested in seeing where this leads. I get a feeling the Borg cube is going to get activated again, which is dangerous, but exciting. So, yeah, we're going to jump in anyway. Enough of me rambling on. I can't even ramble, right? But before we do, I want to say a big thank you to my Patreon super supporters, Frank Tremel, The Lone Detective, Karen Abel, Rakoon Shampoo, Flawed Otaku, Ace, Nick Walters, The Seven Deadly Sins, and Damon Smallwood. So, without further ado, let's jump in and see what happens next.
If you can.
So they're about to see what could happen. That's the drone. She was part of the Jadvash? I didn't know that. she was the only one that stood up to it. Whoa, what? Whoa, okay, this is dark. What? Holy shit, no. Holy fuck.
Call Mars.
So they're the ones who...
Auntie? Auntie.
Were they the ones who made the mech, the synths attack Mars?
Yeah.
And then she got assimilated.
Breaking a Borg cube and the sheer force of your despair.
Was it the vision?
Picked the wrong Talshi, our ship, to assimilate that day.
Oh shit, is that what caused it? They tapped into her memories and saw that...
Pick nine.
Admonishment? Admonition, whatever it's called.
Resistance.
Oh, ow! I love the sound of the punch making a crunching noise. Se1! How did she get on board?
What?
And what's the nearest starbase?
Deep Space 12.
Lay in a court.
I was really hoping he was going to say Deep Space 9. I want to see Deep Space 9 again.
Lay in a course.
Why is he so messed up?
Tell me, JL. What is Soji really like? Do you know? Does she?
It is a good point. He used to be a bit more cynical.
Yeah.
He's become a bit too trusting.
Where are you going, Rakoon?
Because it's very personal
tell
to him.
Reels, I was right about Jurati.
Then I'm sorry, but you are a waste of space.
Admiral Picard, with all due respect and at long last, shut the fuck up. I'm sending a squadron to rendezvous with you at the
airport.
I'll stay put until they get there.
I don't like the swearing in it, but that was a little funny quip.
All right, buddy.
Jana.
Her name is Soji.
Was there a third?
Ask me about astro navigation.
Hold on, was there a third?
This caught my eye while I was surveilling the cube. All these Romulans.
Or was she modeled off of someone else? An actual person?
Circles, see?
I wonder if this cube has like a sphere inside of it? Or a diamond? Uh oh. Oh no, things are going green.
Very gentle. He had a child's wisdom. Unclouded by habit or bias. He made us all laugh. Except when he was trying to make us laugh.
Mm-hmm. He made some terrible jokes.
And you loved him.
Data's capacity for expressing and processing emotion was limited. I suppose we had that in common.
Is that Picard admitting he was not really an emotional person? Which is true.
I might not want to release them.
Yeah. Oh, it's a dilemma for Se1. I'm getting flashbacks.
Maybe this was a mistake.
Did she bring them all together?
Somewhere. Underneath this...
When we arrive, you will surrender yourself to the authorities for the murder of Bruce Maddox.
I love the classic original series sound effects. The medical tricorder.
Now, I think about suicide every day.
And that's why they all killed themselves. Unless did Commander O, Commodore O, try and convert that captain?
She lived through herself.
Drink. You drink when you're thirsty.
Why is she so excited now? She was a minute ago. She was proclaiming hell was coming.
So beautiful.
Like if this had been her before the vision, then yeah.
Picked up a diplomatic mission out of nowhere.
You are a wonder. Technological masterpiece and work of art.
So it's like her fangirling nature is overtaking the memories.
Down.
Who gave the order?
Commodore O.
Commodore O ordered mm-hmm. to kill me.
So were they like earlier versions of her? Did Bruce make them as well?
I would never give you the opportunity.
Oh shit, this is a dark episode. That...
I'm afraid I broke your gun.
Someone get me another. You can't make a joke after killing 20-odd people.
The lights are going up.
We are bored.
Oh, shit. Oh, fuck, that is cool. I wish you'd have said we are the Borg, though. Not we are Borg. Oh, shit.
I've been searching for this world ever since.
Which they have now found because of me.
Oh, shit.
Excuse me.
The ice cream stayed perfectly still.
At this speed, we're about 9 hours from the nearest node.
I thought that was destroyed.
I know how I know that. I must have picked it up on the cube while I was busy being Dr. Soji Asha.
Wasn't the transwarp hub destroyed when Voyager went through it?
And what happened to my brother?
And collapsed it?
Even Majid, I suddenly seem to know a whole lot of things.
And hope we get there in time to warn them.
He's in the captain's chair. No, you can't do it yourself. You have to sit there and do make it so or engage.
Actually, I don't know how to work this.
Your plan is just fly into a transwarp conduit, don't set up a structural integrity field, no chroniton field, just...
They're leaving now.
Have all the Borg been...
Are they
yes,
Romulan?
Sir. In an hour, we'll have the XBs mopped up and be ready to embark.
Oh, shit. Oh! Oh, ho, ho, ho. You should not have fucked with the XBs. Oh, she got transported off, the lucky cow.
I hate that he died thinking it was really Starfleet that betrayed him. Betrayed itself.
And when it wasn't, it's the Jodvash.
We did betray ourselves long before O gave Vandermeer that order. The ban itself was a betrayal. Oh, the Jodvash, they set the trap. We could merely have sidestepped it.
We're there.
Oh dear. I'm assuming they got there first before the Romulan fleet. Oh, that's the transwarp hub. Okay, so another really, really good episode. I'd put that right up there with last week's episode. That really opens up a lot of the picture of what's been going on here. And kind of gives us a clear timeline, an understanding of, you know, why this has happened in the first place. The one thing I will say about this episode is it's extremely dark. And in a lot of circumstances, that would not work very well for Star Trek. Star Trek can have dark moments, no doubt. But typically speaking, you never got anything that dark. I mean, we saw hundreds of thousands of drones murdered when they were sucked out into space. We saw the drones getting shot helplessly. We saw Romulans killing themselves in all dreadful manner of ways. You know, we're hearing about how Starfleet captains were ordered to murder innocent people. So it was a very dark episode, but in a way, it was offset by some really good dialogue and some really, really, you know, impressive moments. The one thing I'd say I was a little bit disappointed with is in the preview, they built up more about what was going to happen with the Borg cube than what actually happened. I would really like to have seen Seven take kind of temporary control of the cube and use the cube and even take control of some of the drones. That moment where she connected and she said, "We are Borg." That was like a spine-chilling moment. And that was like a classic Seven of Nine saying. You know, she would constantly say, you know, "We are Borg." And in that moment, Seven of Nine returned and Onika, you know, ceased to be. But in reality, it was just a bit of a tease because she didn't get to control any drones. She didn't even get to move the cube. It was just a case of, you know, it was a moment, I think, for the fans, you know. But you never know, it could have longer lasting impacts. Hacking back into the cube, could that have triggered some kind of an awareness in the collective? Maybe we'll see them in the next season. Who knows? But that storyline is kind of done. I think unless she does take the Borg cube and follows the Romulan ships, then, you know, I don't think we're going to see much from the cube again. She might find a different ship and set off after them on her own. But yeah, I think that's probably... I mean, I can definitely see the Borg cube showing up in the last episode and, like, saving everyone, which would be, like, the ultimate irony, a Borg cube coming to the rescue. But with everything else that happened on this episode, it was... I mean, the revelations of, obviously, there being more than just Darj and Soji who were made in that likeness, and there was this Janna before. It makes me wonder how many of them are there, and why is the same template used, like the same visual template used for multiple synths. There was confirmation that, you know, the Jadvash ordered the attack on Mars, and it was because Dr. Singh, you know, kickstarted this synth evolution that they're afraid is going to bring about the end of, you know, life, I guess. So in one way, I can kind of definitely appreciate from the Romulan point of view that if you were to sit there and go through something that caused a lot of Romulans to kill themselves rather than live with the vision that they saw, I can certainly appreciate from that point of view why they'd probably want to wipe out synths. And so I'm glad that we've at least got a decent rationale for why the villains are doing what they're doing. And it's not just because they hate people. It's because they genuinely believe they're saving the universe and the galaxy from, you know, this threat. And that makes things very interesting because when you have a villain who genuinely believes what they're doing is right, it can make the story so much more intriguing and believable. And that's what we've got here, you know? And I think that's why a lot of the characters have really worked in the show, because you believe in them. You believe that someone like Captain Rios has gone through that breakdown, suffered that loss of the father figure. And as a result, you know, he kind of had, you know, to leave Starfleet and set off on his own. And now he's got these five holograms who are all little bits of him. You know, and then you believe Agnes, who went through that experience and killed Bruce, and she's now kind of sitting there and reevaluating everything that she's gone through. And even Raffi, who's, you know, started off as someone who was in despair, alcoholic, hated Picard, now has gone on this journey and kind of is trying to kick the habit, has grown a lot. Matured a lot, and you know, she now sees what's been going on. So I think the character growth from everyone has been really impressive. The one thing I really liked about this episode was Jean-Luc's talk, you know, with Soji about Data. That really kind of made me feel good, you know, talking about who he was and how he would have viewed, you know, Picard. I really liked that. I thought it was a very well done, you know, and if someone who didn't have a lot of knowledge about Star Trek had written a scene like that, you would tell immediately. So you can tell they've gone in and done a bit of their research. The only thing I would say when it comes to research is they do have to distinguish, you know, the fact that something is new. So I'll take this transwarp hub, for example. The idea of a transwarp hub only came up at the very end of Voyager. And in their series, it was explained as there is one of six apertures. Like, there's one of six hubs across the galaxy. And you can only enter the transwarp hub from one of those, you know, collected sort of sets of apertures. you can exit anywhere, but you can't get back in. And then it was destroyed in the finale, in Endgame. And so for now there to be another Transwarp hub there, which you can enter in at any point, kind of confuses me. So I kind of wish they'd gone a different route and they didn't do that, because in my head, like, I've got Voyager canon fighting with this new idea, and I'm like, how does that work? It's a little bit sketchy, but it's a nitpicky point. And I'm assuming what's going to happen here is that Transwarp hub is going to be used probably by the Borg cube to arrive at the planet in like lightning fast time. And they'll show up during the final battle. And that would be so cool. Could you imagine, like, this Romulan fleet is converging on the planet, and then out of nowhere, a Borg cube arrives, and it's Seven connected, and she's like, we are the Borg. You know, you will be assimilated. Resistance is futile. That would be amazing. That'd be so cool. And maybe that's where we're going. Who knows? But so far, a really good episode. I really enjoyed that. And that's been two episodes back-to-back that have been, like, right up there. I'm not saying that I haven't enjoyed some of the other episodes, but this really has kind of convinced me that this is worthy of carrying on and getting a second season, you know. So let me know what you thought of it, please. I'm always interested in getting other people's opinions, especially, you know, people who haven't seen Star Trek before, as to whether you're kind of keeping up with all of the little references and what you think of it from that outside perspective. But in the meantime, thank you for watching, and I will see you for the next episode.